everyone, and welcome to my July favorites 2016. The year is just flying by. I haven't done one of these in a long time, and the reason why is mainly because I don't renew my products that often until I actually completely run out. So I didn't have anything really new to show you, but I have been trying a lot of new things, so I figured I would share with you my favorites for this month. I am going to start with skincare, and these two products are from Origins. I have mentioned this one many times. This is the second tub that I use, and it is their Clear Improvement Active Charcoal Mask to Clear Pores. And I love this. When I am having a bad breakout, this saves my life every single time. Now, this is very drying. I love it because it definitely dries out the breakout and it helps like get rid of it a lot quicker, but it does dry your skin. So I saw this one in the sample aisle at Sephora a few months ago. I think it was back in April. And I decided to get it to kind of like balance this one out, because this one is the Drink Up Intensive Overnight Mask to Quench Skin's Thirst. So it is a very heavy hydrating mask that you leave overnight, and I love it. So when I use this, I use this one right after, sleep with it, and the next morning my skin feels like like baby skin. So I mean, who doesn't want baby skin? They have like the best skin ever. So these in combination together, this is like a perfect combo. My next favorite is also a skincare favorite, and it is a night cream. I had been wanting to get a night cream for a while, but I have a very sensitive skin. I have the type of skin that reacts very easily to all sorts of products, like whether it's a breakout or like a rash. I get rashes very easily, especially if the product has like perfume or is scented. That immediately is gonna give me like a rash on my cheek. I don't know why, it's just how my skin is. So it's very hard for me to find products, you know, that are going to work for me, especially when they tend to be on the pricey side. I don't necessarily want to make the investment. So some of the brands that I've noticed work for me, now I'm French, so I might be biased about this, but I have noticed that French skincare brands tend to be a lot more gentle on your skin. And some of my favorites are Avène, which is very hard to find in the United States, or La Roche-Posay, which you can find at CVS. But I sometimes find that they don't have, the ranges that they have here are not as wide as they might have in France. Like, they don't have all the ranges from that brand. And the third one that I found works very well for sensitive skin is a lot pricier, and that was the reason why I kind of hesitated to get this, but it is Clarins. Clarins is a fantastic brand. It is very high quality, but it is definitely an investment. Now, I have never had an issue with their products. My mom tends to buy their products, and I have tried a few of those along the years, and I've never had a reaction from them. So despite that, when I decided that I wanted to give this one a try, this one is the Multi-Active Nuit, and it targets fine lines, but it's mainly targeting those first fine lines that you get. So probably like late 20s, when you start noticing that, you know, you start to have like those little lines along your eye. At least that's where I noticed it first. This is what that cream is for. So it's not like a heavy anti-aging cream. If you are 50, this is probably not good for you. But I think that for those first lines, this I've been really liking it. But before I even bought this, I asked at Sephora if they could give me a little tub, a little sample tub, just to make sure that my skin didn't react. And they were extremely nice about it, very understanding, and they gave me actually quite a like bit of it. They gave me a very big tub of it, and I was able to use it for like a week and see that it actually didn't get like anything on my skin. I didn't react to it, so I took the plunge, because I mean, this, I'll put the link below. You'll see it's kind of pricey, but I've been using it for, I'd say, like a good 5-6 months at this point, and I love it. I like it a lot. What I really liked about these ranges that they have for different types of skin. So this one is for the normal to combination skin. So it's very targeted. It's not too heavy for me. Like if you had dry skin, you might want to get the, like, I think they have one that's a little heavier. But this one is definitely really good. As you can see, there's still quite a bit of it. So a little goes a long way. And it smells really, really good. Perfect for sensitive skin. So if you're looking for that type of cream, I would recommend this one. Definitely recommend this one. My next two favorites are makeup related, and the first one is a product that got a lot of hype the past couple of months, I would say, if not longer, and it is the Glossier Boy Brow. I have been hearing so much about this, and at first I was like, oh, I don't know if I want to give in to their hype, and then I was like, you know what, I just want to know what it is about and why people are so obsessed with it. And I loved it enough that I put it in these favorites. I love the Glossier customer service. I think they're fantastic, always very helpful, always very responsive. I didn't know what shade to buy and they helped me out. I sent a picture of my face and they told me immediately which shade I should get depending on the result that I wanted. And I wanted something natural. So I went for the brown one and I'm wearing it right now. I like that it doesn't look heavy. It does give a little more definition to my brows without looking like they're wearing a ton of makeup. But what I like the most is that my eyebrows actually stay in place the whole day. So I can wear this for 8 hours and my eyebrows are still like, they're not like all brushed up like it happens sometimes. The second makeup product is this Clinique. It's like one of those chubby stick. It's like a lip gloss but in a pencil form. And the one that I have is Mega Melon, and that's what I'm wearing right now. I love this shade for the summer. I think it is very, very pretty and natural. Kind of like one of those like my lip color, but better colors. So I have been using this. I like putting it, like just throwing it in my purse. So if I want to use it, I have it there. My last two favorites are not beauty related, but they're still things that I've loved and that I've been using for, I think, the past couple of months. The first one is this book. This is, well, it's a notebook, not a book, duh. It is from the brand Luchtrum. I don't know how to pronounce it. I believe it might be German. Yeah, Luchtrum 1917. Just correct me if I don't pronounce it. I might be butchering this name. But this is their dotted journal, I believe. I'm not even sure that's how it's called, but I'll put the link below and you can see how it's like, what the name is. I have been looking for kind of like a planner for ever, and I never end up using the planners because I never adapt to what I want. And then I found this thing called a bullet journal and I did a lot of research about it and I thought it was a fantastic idea. I like that you can customize it to what you want and adapt it, and you don't have like a limited amount of space per day. And I've loved this, so I've been using it for that, like this. And the reason why I liked this one is because it's dotted. So it kind of gives you a guideline of where to write, so it's kind of straight, but it still allows you like to do drawings or to do diagrams or things like that. This, for example, is a little tracker that I did to kind of track what I do. So if I manage to not go to Starbucks one day, well, I will not catch it. I was trying to track how often I go to Starbucks, and the conclusion is I go way too often. I like tracking, for example, if I go swimming, so to see, you know, how many times I went swimming in the month. But I've been loving this notebook and I've been loving the bullet journal system. And I will also link below some of the articles that I read about it. There's this one girl that does like YouTube videos about it and she's really, really good at explaining. My next favorite is a book, and this book is Los Lobos number 7. I have been looking for a good book with kind of like to get ideas and inspiration for logos. I really like graphic design as a hobby. I do not work in it, but I do love it a lot. And my cousin is an interior designer and she recommended that I check out this book. And as always, she didn't disappoint me. I love this. I think it's really, really good. If you're looking, for example, to do like a logo for your blog or something, or even your brand if you have a small business, this type of book is awesome because it kind of shows you like all these different type of logos from like different styles, different like industries, and it can just give you an idea of what feel you want and what you want your logo to look like. So I would definitely recommend, if you like design or if you're working into design, to get one of these books, because they are so pretty, very good quality, very good like pictures, and so much variety of examples. So that was it for my July 2016 favorites. Thank you so much for watching. Don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed this, or subscribe if you haven't subscribed. I post videos every week. And let me know what your favorites were this month. I would love to know.